Hi everyone, I'm Henry Shevlin and I'm an AI ethicist and philosopher of cognitive science based at the University of Cambridge at the Leverhulme Centre for the Future of Intelligence. This has been a dizzying and dazzling year for AI, with language models like ChatGPT at the forefront. Back in January, ChatGPT was still pretty new, catching media attention but not fully integrated into people's workflows yet. It was unpredictable, doing things like confessing love to a journalist and threatening to hijack nuclear codes. Not the usual behaviours we expect from a Microsoft product. Similarly, Google's Bard, their version of ChatGPT, made rather dramatic errors in a high-profile demo, causing a slump in Google's stock price. These moments were a bit of a departure from the tech industry's usual standard of polished perfection, and it was around this time that people began noticing that language models would sometimes just make stuff up. They'd hallucinate, as the new jargon put it. This wasn't just from flawed data or algorithmic errors, as is sometimes the case for AI, but rather from the inherent design of current models, which use pattern recognition over rigid rules. And this is rather like something called the DRM paradigm in psychology. Essentially, this relies on the fact that if someone hears words like ship, sailor, navy, and so forth, they might mistakenly think they heard the word boat as part of that list due to its association, despite not being mentioned specifically. It's similar to the issues that AI has, where it relies on semantic links and associations rather than strict knowledge or strict logic. Nonetheless, I think this year will probably be the high watermark of worries about AI hallucinations for three reasons. First, efforts by firms like OpenAI and Google are curbing the frequency of hallucinations, happening less often, seen in the leap from the rather more whimsical GPT 3.5 to the more sober GPT 4, thanks to better tuning from human feedback. Second, users are learning what to trust large language models with. The Avianca incident earlier this year, where ChatGPT embarrassed a legal team by churning out bogus legal cases, shows the early naivety. Now, though, professionals are adapting, using these models wisely while remaining cautious in critical areas. Finally, the shift to specialized models will diminish hallucinations. Unlike ChatGPT, which was fed and trained on a mixed bag of information, specialized fine-tuning is honing models for precise performance in critical tasks, like law and medicine, improving reliability and relevance. Our troubles with AI are not finished, though. Hallucinations involve factual errors and are usually fairly recognizable, like giving London instead of Paris as the capital of France. But as we come to depend more and more on AI for decision-making, we'll face murkier challenges once we move into areas like politics and ethics, where the right answers aren't so obvious. Seeking AI advice on what to study at university or who to vote for delves into what we philosophers call normative territory, beyond simple scientific or common sense facts. There's one other respect in which hallucinations are just the taste of things to come. It's striking to me that of all the words we could have collectively decided on to describe the mistakes that large language models make, we went with hallucinate, when existing computer-specific terms like glitches or bugs could have perfectly sufficed. Perhaps we chose this vivid psychological verb because it's so easy to anthropomorphize these systems, treating them as if they had minds of their own. Already many people think of ChatGPT as closer to a coworker rather than just another app or utility, a shift that's been reinforced by OpenAI's introduction of voice functionality, which has led to engaging discussions on complex topics with the system being possible for those of us who have to drive a lot for work, or even just doing your ironing. As more apps like Pi and Replica begin catering to these social needs explicitly and facilitating voice conversations or even video chats, I expect that social AI will become increasingly mainstream, being used for friendship and romance by the general public, especially young people. Soon, I suspect that many of us will become convinced, rightly or wrongly, that our AI friends or lovers are more than mere algorithms. This is the really bizarre future that I think the word hallucination portends, one in which we enthusiastically, but perhaps mistakenly, expand our psychological vocabulary from the limited world of humans and animals to include AIs. At that point, rather than the AIs being the ones hallucinating, arguably it'll be us.